Greetings. My name is Shirley Ann Kaska, and welcome to my presentation, Andragogy in Practice, Expanding the Usefulness of the Andragogy Model. At this point in our class, we understand the term andragogy and its meaning, being a process of engaging adult learners with the structure of a learning experience. As a beginning instructor of adult learning myself, this subject has been very motivating. As most of you would agree, based on a few of your voice threads, the andragogy is not a complete theory, but a model of healthy assumptions about adult learning. It is one piece of a mosaic. It is important we understand first the difference between pedagogy and andragogy. Having the exact recipe for a product versus focusing on the outcome and how it best fits the recipient. Do they want to learn? How do they feel about themselves? Do they have confidence in themselves? What should they already know before this learning experience? Should the product subject be life-centered? Do they really want to know? These are the questions that we would ask using andragogy. Like most principles, the core andragogy principles have been a progression over time. Our textbook, The Adult Learner, provides a good insight of what the author, Mel Knowles, and his colleagues taught. The changes and dates of additions in core andragogy principles are summarized here. These are rich principles, with two being added in the late 80s, one being need to know and the other motivation. I think it's ironic how they both are so interrelated. Knowing why you need to know something should be a significant motivator. However, all six principles are rich and relate to each other. As you can see, though, all of these are surprisingly new and certainly not much older than most of us, especially me. Now that we understand the difference between andragogy and pedagogy, and a little history, our challenge is tackling each one of these components and really putting the model into practice. Traditionally, we've addressed a few components, but not on the whole. We're starting to do that with new courses that we bring in, but we should be very mindful of the components and the model in order to make it work. I bolded motivation because I feel this has such a big impact on all the components, don't you? I will be discussing later how to analyze the learner using a table with questions to better prepare for this. The beauty of this principle is the flexibility it provides to the user. Is it like a cookie recipe? No, it is not a recipe, but a tool to assist us complete our purpose for instruction. I apologize for the simplicity of this complex subject using a cookie recipe, but I found it helpful for me in applying it. Looking at the six core assumptions principles of andragogy again, let's look at the three-dimensional table. We've discussed the six principles, but as you note, these principles are engulfed by goals and purposes of learning, which is the outer ring, which shape the mold the learning experiences are, and then the inner ring, which engulfs the individual, the situational differences. The outer rings are portrayed as developmental outcomes, the individual, institutional growth, and the society growth. The individual could be, are the cookies for me? Institutional, are the cookies for us? And society, are the cookies for everyone? Obviously, goals and purpose of learning transaction and influence how the core principles fit a given situation. Where is the mission for these cookies? Individual and situational differences. Now the inner circle. Individual and situational differences are portrayed as variables. The differences that impact adult learning and that act as filters that shape the practice of the andragogy. The subject matter. This may require different learning strategies. For example, an individual may be less likely to learn complex technical subject matter in a self-directed format. Situational differences. The category captures any unique factors that could arise in a particular learning situation. For example, the learners in a remote location may be forced to rely on self-directed learning. And then last, the individual differences. Lots of research in the last few years on which and how individual differences affect the learning process. The subject matter. Is it French or good old Southern Texas cookies? The situation, is it for mom or a chef's fine bakery? What about the individual differences? Who doesn't love sugar cookies? I personally see where individual differences will play a bigger role in future studies, with our becoming smaller and cultures overlapping. I look forward to studying intercultural training and hope most of you will be there too. Adult development is another difference that is rapidly expanding. Physical changes, cognitive or intellectual development, and personality and lifespan role development. Knowing these differences will help make andragogy more effective. Is it safe to assume everyone has baked in a kitchen before? Or will the instructor need visual tools to demonstrate? Do they have the eyesight to see? Do they have the kitchen to bake? Here is the recipe for sugar cookies. Is it true? For success, you must be exact? No. My answer is based on this class is no. There are many recipes for sugar cookies. You will know the best recipe when you apply the andragogy learner analysis. You ask why? Because andragogy is not a theory, but a roadmap that we can alter and modify as we go. Thank you, Nancy Johnson, for sharing this in your voice thread. This is the practical model to determine the extent to which the andragogy principles fit a particular situation. You study when are adults most ready for learning, most need learning, and when they may be most motivated to learn. How do we apply these core principles that provide a sound foundation for planning adult learning experiences? This chart can be a tool to assist you in making adjustments as you analyze the particular learner and their individual characteristics, the characteristics of the subject matter, the characteristics of the particular situation. The goals and purposes also shape the learning experience. If you don't have an opportunity to analyze the learners in advance, it would be best to start with the core principles and make adjustments as you go along. If you are not able to print this PowerPoint as a worksheet, let me know and I'll email you. I recommend using this table before finalizing your instruction. The worksheet will assist you in analyzing the individual and situational differences and the goals and purpose for learning. I learned best with examples, and I want to review quickly the examples on this worksheet. Also, it's in your textbook. In this example, the students are disadvantaged citizens, unable to drive hard labor jobs, and they really lack basic literacy skills. You can see in this example that number two is weak because the learner has a history of not being successful and could lack confidence. We also see that number six is strong with motivation high because they are trapped in low-paying jobs and anxious to improve jobs. Also, five is strong in life-centered teaching. You wouldn't want to teach a GED-type teaching. I would print this also as a guide along with your previous table. I also agree with Christy in her voice thread. If we can't facilitate the learning, goals don't matter. Yes, we have come a long way, but there is always room for improvement. As we use andragogy and with research being done, even more theory will be revealed. My contribution would be the importance of believing in ourselves. And the question is, how important is believing in ourselves? Thank you for your time. I hope you will use this practice model presented today to further determine the extent of which andragogy principles best fit your particular situation and improve your application. Again, to refer back to the previous question, yes, I think believing in ourselves could be a very good learning principle and a new one. I hope this is an area we can tap into. The Boston Red Sox may be able to shed some light. Even the Dallas Cowboys. Sometimes we can't always try and remember our favorite things. Thank you for your time.